A school administrator will assign each student in group of n students to one of the m classrooms, where the range of m and n are given like this: m is between 3 and 13 and n is greater than 13. Is it possible to assign n students to one of the m classrooms so that each student has the same number of students assigned to it? So the first thing that we need to do is just understand that when is this possible and when is this not possible. Suppose if we have 20 students, can we assign them in 4 classes equally? The answer is yes. If you have 20 students, can we assign them in 5 classes equally? The answer is yes. If you have 20 students, can we assign them in 6 classes equally? The answer is no. Which means the answer is yes when the number of classrooms is a factor of the number of students. And the answer is no when the number of classrooms is not a factor of number of students. So the question is only asking, is the number of students n over the classrooms is an integer or not? Because if it's an integer, then the answer will be yes. If it's not an integer, the answer will be no, because the students cannot be equally assigned to m classrooms in that case. Now let's start with the first statement. The first statement says that it is possible to assign 3n students to m classrooms, which means that 3n is divisible by m, so 3n upon m is an integer. But now that we have this fact, is n divisible by m? So let's just quickly check. In such statements, it's very important that we try to prove that this statement is not sufficient. So I would like to choose some smart numbers. Now, case number one, I can choose n equal to 20 and I'm choosing m equal to 5. So this result is an integer and 20 over 5 is also an integer. So the answer to the question is yes. And case number two, I'm choosing the value of n as 20 because it has to be greater than 30. And the value of m, I'm choosing 6. Remember, the idea of choosing this number 6 is the most intelligent thing about this explanation. I'm choosing this denominator, a multiple of 3, so that I can cancel out this factor 3 and the remaining factor can cancel out the 20. But 20 alone is not divisible by 6. So it gives the result as no. Therefore, we say that the first statement alone is not sufficient. But this intention should be clear, the idea should be clear, that denominator, once we took a value which was a factor of n, and second time we took the value which is not a factor of n, but because of the factor 3 available in numerator, it can divide 3n completely. So option A and D are out. Let's check the second statement. The second statement says that it is possible to assign 13n students to m classrooms so that each classroom has the same number of students assigned to it. Which means 13n upon m is definitely an integer. But the question is, now can we do the same experiment that we did in the first statement? And the thing is that earlier we could take the denominator 6 a multiple of 3. But here the denominator m cannot be taken a multiple of 3 because we know that m is less than 13. 13 is a prime number, so 13 has no factor other than 1 and 13. Which means for 13n upon m to be integer, since m has nothing to do with 13, therefore n upon m must be an integer, which leaves the answer to the question as definitely yes, and which means that this statement alone is sufficient to answer the question, and the final answer that we mark is option B. Thank you so much.